said they have a number of people along the side. You can hear it cracking right now. And it's coming, they're bringing up along the side, and all the vehicles are bringing up, coming up right now. The tow truck is bringing it up, but it's going to be difficult to separate these cars. And obviously they don't want one of the cars or two of the cars to slip down the side of the bank and to start the process all over again, especially as night is starting to come in. And of course, too, you have the lights out. You
have the lights out right now, but it'll take a while before we can get all these vehicles on board. Still to be determined is whether or not there are any bodies inside that Toyota Corolla. They'll have to take a while before they can separate these three cars, which are pretty much joined together at this point.
First things first, yes, Rich, is you, the first thing you want to see here is the individuals actually look in the car to see if there is potentially anything in there. We have heard over the course of the last week or so as dive teams have been down and pulling car in and car out after this canal that depending on the condition of the canal, you can see the last car there as there's three vehicles looks relatively clean. And we've heard the experts say the dirtier the vehicle, the longer it's been in the canal. This would indicate that this is potentially the vehicle. They identified it through the license plate a little bit earlier today. It has been a tricky situation for the divers, and it's because it's basically this thing was trapped in a concrete siphon, so to speak, in that canal, and it with visibility 6 inches for these divers in that water, it's been very difficult to maneuver down in there. They compared it to kind of like diving within a cave with no visibility.
Yeah, it's a very complicated canal system within the Delta-Mendota Canal, and really it's all about trying to get from out under a creek. And maybe that's why this car was so hard to get to with this mass of two or three vehicles connected to one another. It could have been stuck within a 15 by 15 inch hole. And we've seen these diagrams. Rich Ibarra has been great about breaking it all down for us. But you can see the crews gathering around those vehicles. It happened far quicker than some of us maybe expected, because for a moment there, it seemed like this was either going to be called off or it was going to take much longer.
But as Rich was indicating, they really felt like they had just a short time frame from a window standpoint of getting this car out this evening with darkness starting to become down there in the canals.